all of us. There are times in our lives that we pass difficulties. Or difficulties of people we love. And we ask God, where are you now as I need you? I was reading something, a story from the Word of God. It happened on the day of the resurrection of Jesus. So it is at the end of the book of Luke. In chapter 24, and I will start from verse 13. If you don't have a Bible, share with someone that has a Bible. Okay, now let me tell you what happened before we start reading. It is from Luke 24, and I start from there, verse 13. Okay, on a day, on a Friday, that was the day, Jesus was taken and crucified, and all his disciples were hiding. Because they had fear. They couldn't expect and they couldn't understand what happened. They were disappointed, they were sad. And this is how we feel when we have an unexpected difficulty in our life. That is a time that we look around and we say, God, where are you? I need you now.
Okay, let us read verses 13 and 14. Now, that same day, two of them, that means two of the disciples of Jesus, were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem. They were talking with each other about everything that had happened.
They loved Jesus, they were with Jesus. And now they were in such a big need. And Jesus was not with
them.
And they were speaking about the past. About the situation. This is what we do also. When something bad happens, we find our friends and we start talking about what happened. Oh, this thing happened and I wish it was not like this. Why did it happen? And many times our mind is confused. Is it because I did something? Is it because of the someone else? Why? So all these things confuse our mind. And these two men, they were confused. They were talking, they tried to understand. මේ ස්ථානසිට මනුෂ්‍යයන් දෙදෙනාත් එයා කාරේ විවෘතාවෙන් පත් වෙලා ඔවුන්ට හැම දෙයක්ම සරලව තේරුම් ගන්න උත්සාහ ගන්නවා.
And they felt alone.
ඔවුන්ට තනිකම දැනුණා.
For 3 years Jesus was with them all the time.
යේසුස් වහන්සේ අවුරුදුනක කාලයක් තිස්සේ ඔවුන් සමග සිටියා.
And now they were in need and Jesus was not with them.
මේ අවස්ථාවේ යේසුස් වහන්සේ ඔවුන්ට අවශ්‍ය වෙලාවේ උන්වහන්සේ ඔවුන් සමග නැහැ.
Where are you Jesus now that we need you?
යේසුස් වහන්සේ ඔබ කොහෙද මේ වෙලාවේ අපට උන්වහන්සේ අවශ්‍යයි?
Why did you leave us?
ඇයි ඔබ මාසය අපව අතහැරලා ගියේ?
And then they remembered possibly the miracles of Jesus. The things he has done in their life. The comfort, the encouragement. Other times that he helped them out from a difficult situation. And then they tried to understand. What is happening? Why I am passing this? Just like us. We ask the same questions when we pass difficult times. Now, let's see what happened after that. Let's go to Luke 24, 15 and 16. As they talked and discussed these things with each other, Jesus himself came up and walked along with them. But they were kept from recognizing him.
තවද ඔවුන් කතා කරමින් විචාරමින් සිටියදී යේසුස් වහන්සේම ඔවුන් ළඟට පැමිණ ඔවුන් සමග ගියසේක. ඔවුන් වහන්සේ නාතුළුන් ලෙස ඔවුන්ගේ ඇස් වැදී තිබුණේය.
They were asking themselves, where is Jesus now that we need him?
ඔවුන් විසින් අසමින් සිටියා කොහෙද යේසුස් වහන්සේ කියලා.
And Jesus comes and walks with them, but they cannot understand that it is Jesus.
Jesus was a family of some of the government and Mr. Namuto.
They were so confused in the mind. And their eyes were closed to understand. So they were talking about Jesus. All the good things he has done. The blind people that saw and the paralyzed that walked. And all the things that Jesus did, and still they had questions, where is Jesus now? Many times when we pass this difficulty, we find our friends. We discussed about what happened. And then we remember some details. And we tried to find some explanations. And we tried to find solutions. And then we say, okay, Jesus, where are you? I need you now.
In first of all, Jesus was the one who made the world shake.
And where was Jesus?
Where did Jesus was sitting?
He was with them.
And where was he was sitting?
Many times we are blind like this man.
How did we manage to know that we are the ones sitting now?
But praise God, Jesus is patient with us.
So I know as much as I am, I don't know as much as I am sitting now.
Amen.
Amen. So, in verse 17, let's read half of the verse. He asked them, what are you discussing together as you walk along? What are you talking about? What questions do you have and you just discuss?
ඔබට තිබෙන ප්‍රශ්නේ මොකද්ද මේ මෙච්චර ඔබ සාකච්ඡා කරන මේ පසු වන්නේ?
What is bothering you?
මොකද්ද ඔබට තිබෙන ඔබේ කාරණය?
What is confusing you?
ඔබට තිබෙන ඔබේ වියවුල්කම මොකද්ද?
Jesus is asking the same thing to us.
Jesus wants me karna mada penu dasanama
because he sees in our mind we have questions
un wase dakina apage manasthula me apage sitta sitta thula me hama karane me tibena bawa
because at the times that we are in need usually is the times that we remember god and we say god where are you
apri prashne gathina velawa un wase matak karana velawa di api kena swamini wase kohe api dana un wase api tikinda bawa
now that I need you you are not here
මම මේ වෙලාවේ ඔබ අවශ්‍ය කරන මාත් එක නැහැ.
That is when we start praying.
අපි මෙන්න මෙයා කරද්දි අපි යාඥා කරන පටන් ගන්නෙ.
Now Jesus is waiting from you to ask him the questions.
Jesus වහන්සේ බලාසිට ඔබගේ උන්වහන්සේ කැමති ඔබගේ ප්‍රශ්න අසන්නට.
Because he's waiting from you to ask what is in your heart. Tell me.
උන්වහන්සේ බලාගෙන ඉන්න ඔබගේ හදවත තිබෙන කාරණේ උන්වහන්සේ අසනු පිණිස.
And this is what he asked them.
මේ මේ උන්වහන්සේ ඔබට ඇසුවේ
You are so confused tell me what are you talking about
ඔබ මේ තරම් වියුල්ලා සිටනවා මේ කාරණේ මොකද මම කියන්නේ
And look at the second part of verse 17
17 වෙනි පදයේ අපි දෙවෙනි කොටස එක අපි කියවමු
They stood still their faces downcast
ඔව් දුක්ඛිත මූණු වලින් යුක්තව නැවතුණෝය
You don't know
Oh,
we are passing all these difficulties and you don't know.
අපි මේ පසු කරන අමාරු කම්තු ඔබ දකබලන්න ඔබට පේන්නේ නැද්ද? ඔබ දන්නේ නැද්ද?
Sometimes things are simple when we see Jesus.
අපි සමහර කාරණා දකිတဲ့ව සරල නමුත් අපි යේසුස් වහන්සේලා අපි දකිනවා.
But when we let our mind be confused trying to find answers, our eyes closed and we cannot see Jesus.
අපගේ මනසම අපි ගන්නවා වියුල් කම නැත්නම් යේසුස් වහන්සේ අපි ඈත් වී ගිය බව අපි තේරුම් ගන්න උත්සාහ කරනවා.
So when Jesus asks, what is bothering you? Tell me.
යේසුස් වහන්සේට ඔබට තිබෙන මේ කාරණය මොකද්ද මට කියන්න?
Tell me clearly.
ඒක පැහැදිලිව මට කියන්න.
Like this people will. What does Jesus want me to tell him?
මොකද යේසුස් වහන්සේ ඔවුන් කියවිය යුතු කාරණය?
Doesn't he know?
ඇයි මොස් දන්නේ දෙක?
Yes, Jesus knows, but he wants you to tell him clearly so you can get answers.
උන්වහන්සේ දන්න මොකද කියලා කාරණය මත උන්වහන්සේ අවශ්‍ය ඒ කාරණේ ඔවුන්ට දැනගෙන ඒක පැහැදිලි කරලා දෙන්න ඔවුන්ට.
Because many times when we are confused with questions, our mind goes and travels and we become more sad, more disappointed, more discouraged.
අපි ප්‍රශ්න වලින් අපි ගොඩාක් වියවුල් වෙලා අපි එහෙට මෙහෙට දුව යන වෙලාවදී අප වියවුල් කමෙන් එහෙම නැත්නම් අපි ගොඩක් කනස්සලට පත් වෙලා අපි ගොඩක් දුකට පත් වෙනවා.
So after they understand that he wanted to know this man, this third person,
මේ තුමේ කපුත්කලක අවශ්‍ය නැවුන්ගේ ප්‍රශ්නේ ගැන දැනගන්න
They start again to tell him Jesus was good.
Oh, now the kind that Jesus was so hondai.
He was kind to everybody.
Oh, unwas have again to yahapath unwas karunavantai.
He had the power to do miracles.
Oh, unwas bare tibuna hasam karanta.
He helped us in his life.
Unwas ke jeevit anar udav kala.
And where is he now?
Then unwas bahede.
That was in her mind.
Menne mele unge marasul tibune.
They believed in Jesus but they had questions and they became confused.
Oh Jesus wahanse vishwas kala namo then out me velavadi viyul kama matu na Jesus wahanse kaalne tuladi.
Have you felt the same?
Oba me akara patti thibenawada?
Yes.
Oh.
I'm honest with you. When I heard this thing that happened last week, I said, why? I cannot understand it.
ඔබට අවංකව කිව්වොත් මේ කාලේ පස්සේ දිනවල අසුරු වෙලාවේ ඒ තුන ප්‍රශ්න මත වුණා ඇයි එහෙම සිදු වුනේ?
But I thank God as I was reading his word my eyes opened.
මොලේ යේසුස් වහන්සේගේ වචනේ කියවද්දි මගේ දැස් විවර වුණා.
And this is what I want to tell you. Open your eyes.
ඒකසම ඔබට පවසන්නේ ඔබගේ දැස් විවර කරගන්න.
Yes, I asked the question, where are you Lord now that there is meat.
Mamat eswa ya akar swamine bo han ser kohete me velavide unde pokare avashyai.
And many times we are blind because Jesus is with us.
Bo avastar api andava sinwa Jesus swanse apasa sitia.
Amen. Okay, so they opened their hearts and they spoke to this man that was asking them about their problem. And I believe this is the point where Jesus wants us to start speaking to him. Usually when we pray and we are in need, instead of coming to the need straight, our mouths and our minds go here, there. And we bring more confusion, and at the end we try to explain to Jesus what is happening in our hearts. And Jesus
said,
tell me, don't let the confusion in you. Tell me clearly. And let's go and read 25 to 27. After they opened their hearts, look what Jesus is saying to them. And these words, many times he can speak to us when we behave the same way. He said to them, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. And he said some things. Let's read. Did not the Christ have to suffer these things and then enter his glory? And beginning with Moses, all the prophets, he explained to them what was said in all the scriptures concerning himself. Yes. So he tells them, you are behaving in a foolish way. And he says also, I don't know how it's in your translation, you are slow of heart to believe all the word, all that God has said. Many times we are the same, slow in heart to believe what God says. Do you read your Bible? Yes. Do you know what your Bible tells? Yes. Most of you, I believe you know. Many of you know many parts of the Bible. But when we are passing in difficulty, our heart is slow to believe what God is saying in His word. You forget all the things you read last night. And God says you are foolish. You know God, I say, why you don't believe it? God was not angry for their confusion and their questions. It's natural when we pass from difficult times, our heart asks why. God is not saying we are foolish because we ask why.
අපිට අඥානයෙන් අමාසිකෙන් අපි හැමදේම නොදන්න නිසා නෙවෙයි.
But Jesus is saying, look, you are reading the word of God. You know what God says. Why your heart is slow to believe?
උන්වහන්සේගෙන ඔබ බබමණි වචනේ දන්න වචනම කියවනවා. නමුත් ඔබ වහන්සේ ඔබට මාව විශ්වාස කරව මෙතන ප්‍රමාද වුණේ ඇයි?
That is what we must look to change and see Jesus. Because they could not see and believe what God is saying, they could not see Jesus. But praise God, he has patience. Are you patient with people? Many times I speak with different of you. And especially if you have some responsibility to do in the church. Whether it's team servants, kitchen ministry, and I hear many times this. These people don't understand. I cannot be patient with them. Well, praise God, Jesus is not like us. He's very patient. Very, very patient. So, like here, he told them, okay, you are foolish, you are slow to believe. But what did he do? He explained what the word of God is saying. He reminded them. Last night you read this. That God says in the word of God. And last week you read this. So he explained to them. Like he's explaining to us. Don't be slow to believe. Take the word of God. You are asking, where is God when I need him? Where is God when I pass from difficulty? What is God saying? Keep your finger there and go to Isaiah
43:1-2.
Isaiah 43:1-2. This part you must learn it by heart if you haven't learned it yet. Because when we are asking, where are you, God? God gives you the answer.
Have you found it?
Yes. All right. But now this is what the Lord says, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. Let's all read it together. Start again. Loud, please.
Okay.
So Jesus reminds them all the words of God.
Jesus once me amastavet me umasiga vashine matak kirimak karadenawa.
Like he reminds you and me.
Harita obata saha mata matak karadenawa wage.
And still they are slow to believe, but their heart is opening slowly.
එතන විශ්වාස කිරීම ප්‍රමාද වීමක් වුණා නමුත් සෙවෙන් සෙවෙන් ඔවුන්ගේ හදවත් විවර වුණා.
And then Jesus does something else.
උන්ව යේසුස් වහන්සේ තවත් යමක් ස්ථාන කළා.
Let's jump to verse 28. Let's go Luke 24. Go back to Luke 24, verse 28.
අපි නැවත යමු ලූක් සුභාචර 24 වෙනි පරිච්ඡේදයේ 28 වෙනි පදයට.
Now remember, their eyes is still closed. They are looking for Jesus, and they cannot see Jesus.
Mata ko tabaane tama tonge dance vesiti bina unta me Jesus swas swatra ganja behe.
They cannot recognize him.
Unwa unta unwa swatra ganja backless againne.
Luke visi hatre, visi hatre.
Luke visi hatre.
No, visi hatre, sorry.
Visi hatre, visi hatre.
Luke visi hatre, visi hatre. As they approached the village to which they were going, Jesus acted as if he were going further. After he explained to them what the word of God says, he says, bye bye. And he pretended that he was going another way. Why was Jesus doing
that?
Was he going to lead them still in their confusion? That is not right. But he wanted them to understand that if they are asking where Jesus is, to call him to come. All the time when we pass from difficulty, we ask, where are you, God? Where are you now that I need you? But Jesus is expecting them to say, Lord, come, I need you.
That is what
he's expecting us to say. Not only to ask, where are you? So Jesus, after reminding the word of God, that is what he does when we come to him. Then he is expecting us to call him, come Lord, I need you, I seek you. And this is what they did. Verse 29. But they urged him strongly, stay with us, for it is nearly evening, the day is almost over. So he went in to stay with them. Amen. So Jesus pretended to go away, and when they called him, of course he went, because this is what he wanted.
Jesus was
at the time of your trouble, call Jesus, come Lord, I need you. And it is a desire of Jesus to come. He wants to be near you. He wants to have fellowship with you. He wants you to know that at the time of difficulty, he is there.
Unwas
Samuel was sitting about her.
Amen. And look what happens. Let's go to verse 30. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and began to give it to them. Amen. Jesus wanted to have fellowship with them. And he did something that they knew. A few days ago, they were together at the table, and this is what Jesus has done. Because Jesus wanted to show them to them that I am here. But he wanted them that they open their eyes. So he did something that they knew only Jesus could do.
Jesus once
and let's go to verse 31. Then their eyes were opened and they recognized him, and he disappeared from their sight. Let's speak about the first part first. They were asking, where are you, Jesus? Now that we need you. And their eyes suddenly opened. And they saw Jesus. He was there with them. All the time they were asking, where are you, Jesus? He was with them. Eyes were closed. Because they forgot the word of God. And they allowed confusion to come into their mind. But now Jesus explained the word of God. And after he was invited to be near them, their eyes opened. Amen.
Amen.
And this is what he's doing in our lives. Now you can ask me a difficult question. Okay, Jesus did all these things to help them understand that he was with them. And when they understand, what does Jesus do? He disappears. Did he go away?
No.
He just became invisible. They could not see him with their eyes. Can you see Jesus with your eyes? No. Do you believe that he is with you?
Yes.
That is the lesson he wanted to teach them. Jesus is here with you at the difficult time. Even when you ask, where are you, Jesus? Jesus tells you, I'm here with you. Open your eyes. I'm here with you. Let me tell you a story that many of you know, or some of you know. A man had a dream. And he saw that he was walking at the beach on the sand. On the sand, at the beach. As he was walking, he was looking up at the sky.
On
the sky, he could see like a cinema, his life. And he saw a lot of pictures of his life from the time he was small. And he remembered that God told him, I will be with you. As he was looking up, then he looked down. And he saw on the sand that there were two sets of footsteps. And he was happy because God was with him. One was his, the other one was God's. But he noticed something. There were times that he saw only one set of footsteps. And then he said to God, God, you said you would be with me. But I noticed the time that I was in great difficulty, your footsteps are not there. And God told him, my child, when you see one pair of footsteps, it's my footsteps, it's not your footsteps. That at a difficult time, I hold you up. I am with you and I will be with you. Jesus is with us. Whatever you are passing through, remember Jesus is with
you.
Even when we are slow in heart to believe, when he tells us, I will be, surely I will be with you all the days until the end of the age. Even if we are slow to believe, he will stay with us.
Amen.
Amen. He is a faithful God. He is the God who is with us all the time.
Amen.
Whatever you are passing through today, or if the difficulties come tomorrow, remember, God says, I am with you. If you pass from the waters, if you pass from the fire, whatever difficulty you pass, I am with you. Amen. And I will hold you up in my arms like that man that you saw in the dream. So don't try to understand with your mind. Don't allow confusion. Open your eyes. Jesus is with you.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you because you are the God who is with us. You are the God who always is with us.
comes your life.
Lord, help us not to be slow in our hearts to believe your word.
Swaminiya bahansa vishwas kar pramadrati dare te paas.
But to have the faith that whatever you say, you are faithful and you will do it.
Swamin bahansa vishwas kar bahansa vishwas kar misrita apne bahansa khana den te.
Don't allow confusion into our minds.
Swamin apne manas mein ye ukhame ente idhi ante idhi te paas.
Don't allow our eyes to be closed so not to see that you are with us.
Swamin vahansa vahansa noda ki na pili sa bage des vese di gale te pa.
But Lord, assure us in our heart that you are always with us.
Swamin apne sahati kya dete swamin vahansa vahansa bage zahma vela vishnu bavata.
Because you say it in your word.
Swamin vahansa bage vachin rupe ava swam.
Many times we have experienced it in the past.
Swamin apne aate hi dete apne bahu atta kinti gale ma.
And we want always to have this assurance that God is with me.
Swamin ya bhavanse apa prasad kehte na bhavanse hama bela ma apa sab Krishna bhavate.
So we will not ask again, Jesus, where are you now that I need you?
Even if we never the prasad se ya ne Yesu swamse bhavoi the man bhava shay kya kya kya.
But to say Jesus, I know that you are with me.
Mama kya kya na mama damo Yesu swamse maapte ke Krishna bhava.
Even if I see a difficult situation, I know Jesus is with me.
Mama dana mama afar ka mai te yana milav Jesus swam se maati ka sitre baba.
And I thank you, Lord.
Mama suti kar maswa.
And I trust you, Lord.
So mama mai te swam vishwas kar maswa.
And I glorify you.
Mama ke naam mein mahi mere babu ne maswa kari.
The name of Jesus.
Jesus swam se ke naam mein.
Glory to Jesus.
Jesus swam se mai ne baba.
Help us to have our eyes open.
Swamini apage des vivarakata prudavente.
The eyes of faith.
Tel adahilla namat des.
We assure us in the heart that you are here, Lord.
Apage hadavatara sahati kyatena bhavansa pasamga sita bhava.
Amen.
Amen.
Before you sit down, if you feel confusion in your mind for some difficult situation you are passing through, remain standing. I want to pray for you. If you are passing a situation and you ask why?
Oh, pasuka namarukam parde vasame sitinona a kya.
Don't expect me to give you the answers, but the word of God will give you the answer.
Oh, mare utra bala portu ante va devan mas vasane tuli obale ke pinu truti venava.
But I want to assure you, Jesus is with you. Don't be discouraged.
Ma par sahati ga kole kiyenama Yesu swase basamaga sitinama.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So those that feel confused, remain standing. The rest of you sit down, please.
Karunata viye un kame ne tam prava obatula sitna viye un kame sitna sitna aye karunata basite sitete anita karunata baan bente.
That God is faithful.
Devyan Mahan se vishwas vartai.
Whatever he says.
Un Mahan se kumak kareva sve.
He does it.
Un Mahan se dekha karna amai.
When he says I'm with you, he is with you.
Un Mahan se o kareva sve mamon basa maga sidna vakila o un Mahan se basa magai. Umu gene yak na karna.
The name of Jesus.
Jesus Mahan se gene amen.
Lord, I ask that you open the spiritual eyes of my sisters.
Swami, mage sahodre ki aap mere desh bade kala menava.
To see that you are standing with them.
Aba vahan se un samaga sitte ke sitte bawda un dehan sala swarna.
And give them peace in their heart.
Aba hadavat me samadhan hai jete.
That whatever difficulty they pass, you will protect them.
Swami, aba sukha namal ka parte bawda rakhabat kala menava.
You will find the way out.
Swami, aba vahan se un dehan sala swarna.
portion.
And they
and that you will take them in your
arms.
And together you will pass through
many difficulties.
I come against any confusion in the name of Jesus. And I ask for a good understanding of the word of God. And an opening of the eyes. Like you opened the eyes of the servant of the prophet
Elisha.
Open the spiritual eyes of my sisters. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, help them. You said you will not let them alone. Help them for a quick solution. The name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Thank you, Lord. Amen.